stream on converting a fusilier from the Operation Ice Storm to a fusilier from the Operation Kaldstrom battle pack. So where we left off last time was on this backpack here, and I'm gonna go ahead and finish that up today, and I'm gonna go ahead and try to see if I can't get around to doing the goggles as well as cleaning up this beret, because I was originally thinking of putting the goggles up on here, but the female Fusilier from Operation Kaldstrom already has her goggles up on her head, so I thought it'd be kind of fun to maybe put them over her eyes this time instead, just to make it look that much more different than the one that comes in the battle pack, but also look the same. So I'm going to go ahead and mix up some green stuff. It's nearly a disaster. It's nice to have a little bit of excitement on this stream every now and then. Some action adventure. So we're just going to take a look at the test model that I've been working off of, or not test model, basically example model, because this is from Operation Kaldstrom. We're just going to take a look at that backpack real quick, maybe get my camera to focus on it, instead of something stupid in the background. Hold on a second, I'm going to see if I can adjust some things so that that didn't continue to happen. Because otherwise, it's going to make it very difficult to see what I'm doing. It won't stay focused on the model. Okay, and then we also have our reference photo here. And this is the concept for the backpack here that we're trying to achieve as well. So I'm going to be kind of jumping back and forth between looking at the model that I have here. Probably mostly going to go off of this model because this is what it actually looks like in person. And sometimes concepts can be a little bit, maybe just small details off, or you might interpret something wrong. Or it might be something held over from the original sculptor who interpreted something wrong. So I always like to go off the physical model to see what that looks like if I'm trying to copy the model itself. If I was just trying to copy the concept, then I would just rely on the concept and ignore the model. But since this is kind of a uniform army, not like a special character or something like that, I'm trying to follow along to those the standards of that are set forward by the actual model that they produced rather than the concept. So I'm going to be using a different tool than I had been, a different metal tool. So this one's just got this shape on it, and I'm just using it because the other one seemed to have gotten a little small bend in it. It can be slightly frustrating to deal with. wants to try and focus on everything about the model at the moment. Slightly obnoxious. It might be because I did a little bit of painting, and you can kind of see some of the spray here from bleeding through the other side of the paper, so it's possible. But the camera's trying to pick up on that, which is... Then I also spilled some water, so it's almost like it's seeing those in the background, and it just wants to zoom in on those. It's really quite annoying. Probably doesn't help that I flipped my camera around earlier. An accident. Alright, so I'm kind of making, looks like it's a fried egg on her back at this point. But I'm just trying to get the basic kind of shapes before I do a whole lot of extra sculpting on top of this. I think I'm going to go ahead and just add a little bit of more green stuff to it to get kind of those basic shapes and to make it protrude kind of as much as it should. just kind of comparing. It's looking quite a bit different, which I don't particularly like, so I'm going to have to keep fudging it. Keep fiddling with the model that I'm working on here. Actually, I think this section here should maybe be a little bit thicker. I kind of spread it a little too thin, I think. That's easy enough to remedy. So one thing is that this is looking a little flat, should be more rounded. And I'm eventually going to need to grab another tool. Now I'm just trying to make sure this is mostly the right shape. The right shape as possible. Okay, so this time I'm using this rubber tip tool, which kind of has a, it's almost like circular, but then it's cut horizontally. And this can be useful for kind of making a little more rounded shapes within things. So I'm going to be pressing in and kind of working it to make that interior look a little bit rounder. Again, if I wasn't streaming, I might do this in a lot more settings, because I could then just make this one shape, get that just right, and then layer it over, and that makes your life a whole lot easier than trying to kind of do multiple shapes on top of each other, because otherwise you'll often find that they end up starting to want to blend into each other, and it makes it difficult to really put some of the detail work into it as easily. It just makes your job a lot harder when you're working purely with the white and green stuff. that shape is looking pretty good now. I mean, it's not 100% match, but I'm getting pretty happy with it. I think I'm almost ready to start adding a little more detail. Put a little bit of water in there to make it so that my tools wouldn't stick, but it's getting to be too much to really see. I'm beginning to kind of obscure some of my detail. I just had to quickly blow it out. And kind of got three lights in here that are just on each side. I'm just going to try and make those as evenly as possible. Oh, this is frustrating for the camera. And of course I can't get it to autofocus. This is frustrating. Seems to focus on my fingers just fine. There we go. So it looks gross and terrible. So I'm gonna have to see if I can't clean it up just a little bit. That's just gonna require a lot of back and forth between my different tools. it's looking pretty good. There's one small tiny detail that I'm gonna just add a little more green stuff to accomplish, but I don't want to add too much. It's probably, slightly be better. Okay, so now I need to kind of add these bits here. Again, just a little bit more green stuff. This is just, the same stuff that I mixed up before. I knew that I'd be doing quite a bit of work, so I wanted to have a good amount left over so that I wouldn't have to kind of take a break and mix more up. That's one thing I like to do, is if I'm trying to get kind of equal halves green stuff, by no means scientific, but I just kind of roll it up on my thumbnail, cut it roughly in two, there you go. Now again, if I was doing this not on a live stream, I would probably let all that work I did dry. We're going on to this portion. mainly because, if I press too far into the work I've already done, then I spoil what I already just worked on. That can be a bit frustrating, but... I just have to be careful. I think what I'm going to try and do is get one side how I want it, and then just kind of try and copy it on the other side. That way I'm not kind of trying to fiddle with both and then having to readjust both if they're not matching up to the comparison model. so now what I need to do, kind of those lights there, and so there's a couple different ways I could try to do these buttons. One would be to kind of just make a divot out of the on the back where they're gonna go, and then just put kind of a ball and flatten that out. But I'm gonna try another trick real quick. This is something that I like to do kind of for buttons. If I'm doing like studs or things like that, you can do. So it's just a mechanical pencil. What I'm doing, this is going to be a little bit smaller than I really need, but I do think it's worth. So what I'll do is I'll just kind of dip that point into some water. Then you just press it in. That gives me a great start. Somebody's listening to some loud TV. Alright, there we have our kind of our backlights. I think once this is dry, I may add a little bit more kind of to that button there, but that's kind of gives me a little pretty nice start there. And just looking at my backpack, comparing them, this one maybe comes out a little bit much, a little bit further than it should. So I'm going to go ahead, I'm not saying I was going to wait until it's dry, but I kind of want to see if I can finish this tonight. I'm just going to take two bits. Green stuff to add to those lights to make them actually kind of protrude a little bit more outside of the backpack like they do on the other model. Sure to put my X-Acto knife the right way so I don't end up stabbing myself in the arm while I'm moving around. So now those are protruding a little bit. That looks much more in line with the model I'm working from. So now all I need to do, you know what? There's a few more straps I wasn't paying attention to. Let's finish those up real quick. I do want to have everything on the backpack completed for sure. That's probably enough. Kind of like what I did with those bits on top. I'm gonna try and go ahead and just sculpt one side first, and then get that as close as possible, and then kind of just use that as to mirror off of. So I did say that I was going to try and finish sculpting one side before moving on to the other, but I just realized that I got impatient and didn't, so now I'm just getting basic shapes of both. Which kind of sometimes all you need to do before you can start mirroring or adding more detail. Main thing is you don't want to do it all just comes down to what works best for you. I gotta realize that I wanted to make sure that both sides were pretty equidistant and looking correct next to each other before I go on and start sculpting too much on either side. comparison, and I think that helps it out quite a bit. There we go, I just need to adjust the light. That seems to bring things into focus a lot better. Alright, so I feel like I've pretty much finished the backpack there. Maybe touch up a couple spots here and there. See if I can kind of crank out that those goggles. See if we can't finish this model up. And try to be very, very careful not to stick my fingers into the backpack. And it may prompt me to kind of call it quits early before finishing the goggles, because I actually really want to put my finger here to embrace that model. And I know that if I'm not super diligent, that's what I'm going to end up doing. And I don't want to just keep redoing the work that I already did. So instead, I will just stop. Let that dry and come back and finish this another day. There we go, goggles. Are hopefully should be able to get this in fairly quick, because they are very simple. They just have a very simple strap. There's no connectors on them, so really it's just about getting that shape correctly put on there, and then just doing that line for kind of the frame of the goggles. That looks more daunting than it really is. Just takes practice with those type of things. Kind of always does. And then I cut pretty deeply into the hair because I wanted the strap to really look like it's wrapping around the head and holding tight rather than kind of just floating on top of the hair. So I won't be needing to make that strap and then just clean up the hair as well. Make it look like that hair is tucking into that, or under that strap, rather than even them being kind of side by side. It would look silly. But it looks really silly if that strap looks like it's not pressing the hair down at all. Just kind of makes it look odd. I mean, it's not something you necessarily put your finger on when looking at something like that. But it'll look off, and you might not be able to grasp what the issue is. That's one thing that's, I find really with any type of painting and things like that, is that sometimes if you make a mistake, you might not understand why it's looking wrong until you've got a lot more practice, and then you will be able to kind of spot those things. It's kind of like, you know, if shadow is pointing the wrong way on something that you're painting. You know, if you see a painting, it'll just look off if the shadow's pointing the wrong way, or if the shadows aren't matching up, and it might be hard to articulate until you get a little bit more understanding yourself of shadows. But it's something that you can kind of always spot. So I got the basic shape on there. Now I'm just going to make the strap and the hair, and then also fix up that beret. Okay. Almost came close to putting my thumb in the backpack. I'll just grab my needle tool. Press it in that way. That way, I don't have to worry about it. Now, what I can do here, because I went ahead and cut deeply into that hair, I can kind of just take this and just straighten it out there. Basically, I'm just filling up that gap that I had that was left by me cutting into the hair there. This way I can hopefully get a pretty smooth transition from the hair to the green stuff, or from the metal to the green stuff. Okay. So now, it might seem odd that I was talking about wanting to make the hair look like it's not floating, and then I just basically patched it up, but this then allows me to do this, and gives me a little bit of material to work with. For the hair as well. I'm starting to get distracted by whatever is going on, whatever movie my neighbors are watching. Seems very musical. And loud. A little warm here, so I think everybody just got their windows open. So I'm just kind of trying to add the texture back into the hair. Somebody's really playing with their car out there too. It's kind of fun. Either that or somebody's playing with the microwave. I'm not quite sure. There's a lot of beeping going on. I'm just preparing that very kinda mild it down, because originally I was gonna have the goggles up on her forehead, but I decided the up on the eyes is more interesting. Or down on the eyes. Oops. And like like I said, stuck my fingers right into the backpack and swore because it's very frustrating. Not too bad, but definitely going to require some repair, as you can see. So I'm going to go ahead and wait a minute before I do that. Okay, now I need to kind of quickly make the frames. also makes the same to John Oliver. That's interesting. Cool. I think one thing we have to take into account is that her face is actually kind of tilted. These goggles should be as well. Okay, so I think it's looking pretty good. Maybe he's trying. Work that I'd already done before that I kind of messed up. Make sure I don't stick my finger in the goggles. It's not too bad. And it looks like I'm also probably getting close to my end time because I can feel that the green stuff is a little bit more leathery. Still pretty malleable. But definitely not going to be able to do any type of fine detail or anything like that. But or too fine a detail. Might come out a little bit too rounded if I try and do more at this point, but luckily that is all we have for this mini, and I will call it done after this for this model. And I think there's maybe a few rough spots here and there. I try and get a couple of those. A lot of this would be covered by paint. But, you know, this is something that you're trying to maybe recast or send out to somebody as a gift or commission work. Probably want to try and clean those up. One thing I could do, also just wait until it's good and cured. Take some sandpaper to it. Now that may sound like nonsense, but what you do is if you have really fine fine grit sandpaper, like I'm talking 600 to 800. And really even 400 I think you'll get away with, but, 600, 800, I'm going to do the best. You can actually sand green stuff pretty well. It takes to it pretty well. You can even use a rougher grit, and then just work up to that finer grit. That's basically just like, just like polishing anything else. Like if you're trying to, seeing anybody polish a bit of resin that they worked on, like a resin lamp or something, clear table, resin table, they're gonna use a tougher grit to basically chew into the material and get it even. And then use a finer grit to really just polish it. Make it really nice and smooth so you don't have, you know, deep sanding gouges. Or rough sanding gouges, I should say. Okay. So, here we are. That is our model. This is the model. Our test model, our comparison model. I'm pretty happy with the work I've done here. I think it looked great alongside these Operation Kaldstrom models. Did a little bit of a surface, a hard surface, not a whole lot. So maybe I'll do some more demonstrations on that at some point. What I'm thinking about doing for next week is been modifying some Blood Bowl miniatures, and this guy here, I want to give him, kind of give him some arm spikes, and he has this, you know, braided, or, you know, rope that's basically holding all his armor on, so I want to go ahead and maybe just give him, maybe make those ropes. So I think that could be something that could be useful for folks, is just learning how to make rope. And you know, if I think about it, maybe I'll do some chain too, because that can be useful to learn how to do, just kind of for, well, all kinds of different models, but especially if you want to do something in, like, you know, the 40k Warhammer 40k or Warhammer, maybe something a little more low-tech than, you know, Infinity. But thanks for anybody that's watching, and have a good night.